Okay, I like these guys. Organize your life starting with your cabinets, right? Well, Brett Campbell is the installation manager from Shelf Genie. He's going to tell us a little bit about it. We talk to Jim oftentimes, who he's the guy who sort of goes to the house and talks
Correct.
To the homeowner or the builder or whatever and tells them what they need and what they should have. You're the guy that actually puts it together, so maybe you can tell us more about the product itself than he does in terms of the quality and installing and all
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely. Our factory is in Arizona. They've been making dovetail drawers for a little over 30 years. So it's super high quality, either Baltic birch or furniture grade hardwood, all dovetail joints.
I mean, it's a solid thing.
Yeah, very solid, very good quality. It's not plywood like these you could get at Home Depot.
Yeah.
This is solid Baltic birch. Or furniture grade
yeah,
hardwood.
Yeah, it's put together. And when you take a look at the size of these things, I can pick this up, can I?
Yeah, this is our display.
Look at this.
We take this right into the customer's home.
I mean, the slides are so much different than you see like from a builder's supply one.
Correct. And then we can also upgrade this to an undermount glide as well if they want a soft close.
Yeah.
We'll do an undermount glide that you don't see when you pull the drawer out.
Okay, somebody told me one time that you could put like 150 pounds or 200 pounds in one of these drawers.
We've got 100, 150, and 200 pound rails. So our minimum is 100 pound rails, which is about 75 pounds more than what you'll get in a builder grade drawer,
right?
Like when they build a home. So yeah, ours is an upgrade from your builder stuff that they come.
I got to tell you something. I've got drawers like this. They're perfect. I love them. I got Dutch ovens, big Dutch ovens like I put in the cabinet. And if I didn't have this, I'd have to get on my hands and knees and push them in the back and pull them out. And it's just ridiculous. And
right.
My age, getting on your hands and knees going in the cabinet is sort of ridiculous.
Well, you're like 95% of our customers.
I thought you were going to say I was 95 years old.
No, you're not a day over 84.
Thank you very much. I love this guy. He's a lumber fan. That's 84 lumber, right?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Hey, so down here on the bottom, I love this tray down here. Let's take a look at this thing. It helps you divide up the things that are hard to deal with in your cabinet.
Correct. And we can make these dividers either permanent or you can actually take them out and adjust them so they're infinitely adjustable. So if you've got something larger like your colander here or smaller like your cutting board, you can adjust it any way you want.
Yeah,
so
some of these big dopey things are impossible to take care of without hurting them too.
Right. And this just makes it much easier and you can really tailor it to what's in your kitchen.
Okay, I bought a house 4 years ago. I love the cabinets. They're stylish, they're beautiful, but they're a pain in the butt because it's difficult to get things out. I mean,
sure.
People are putting shelves now all the way to the ceilings, like 8 feet in the air.
Yeah, it gets pretty high.
It gets pretty crazy.
Yeah.
So how do you help a person that's got that situation?
Well, if they do have something that's really high, we can change the profile of the drawer. So if it is real high, we can make it skinnier in the front.
So you can reach over the top.
You can reach over the top. You can see over the top.
Right.
But it still has a high back. So the taller stuff won't fall over.
See, so you folks out there, you got really nice caps and they don't really work for you. They can figure out a solution for you. It's not that they're going to tell you what to do, but they're going to give you some choices that you can try that are really going to work.
Right. And when I come out for the measure, I can explain all that.
Yeah.
After Jim leaves, I'll be giving the customer a call 2 to 3 days later. I go out, measure everything down to a millimeter, and then I come out again to do the installation myself.
So you know what's going on.
Yeah.
And who doesn't have a junk drawer out there? Hands in the air, don't anyone have a junk drawer?
We have two.
You have two. So how can you organize a junk drawer with one of these things? I mean, people throw their bills in there, they got their keys in there.
Absolutely. You can do, like I said, you can either do dividers, or they have inserts that you can put in.
Yeah, like little boxes like that,
Correct.
Right?
Or they have inserts that are already pre-divided, and we can make them custom as well. We can actually, if a customer has an idea of what they want to put in, we can actually make the dividers any shape that they want inside their drawer.
Am I that customer you don't like who starts
we love customers like that.
So you put all that stuff in there, and like you got the stuff in the back, you don't shuffle through it. You can even just pick it up and take it out.
Correct.
And there you go.
Yeah, there's...
It's a good place to hide your nickels and dimes.
The options are limitless.
Hey, so I call you. What happens when we call you? What's the process?
So after you call and Jim comes out and he gives you the free demonstration, the free quote, if you decide to go with it, Jim says, all right, Brett, my installation manager, will be giving you a call. I'll call the customer 2-3 days later, depending on my schedule, and we'll schedule a time for me to come out and get the measurement.
And oftentimes you have special deals going on.
All the time.
Yeah.
Especially for our Fox viewers.
Oh, do you hear that, everybody? So there's a number on the screen right there. You met Jim before, and I tell you, you do a wonderful job.
Thank you.
Yeah, you transform your kitchen. You got a beautiful kitchen. Maybe you should have a kitchen that really works great also.
Right.
So that's the way to go.
Absolutely.
Nice to see you, man.
Thank you
very much. Natalie?
All right, I'm coming over here.
Oh, you already are. Give me a heart attack.
I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm going to go over here with this guy.
Stay okay. Here. They want you to stay here. Here's the deal. We are wrapping up our first hour today. We're going into our second hour.
You scared me.
We had to adjust some things. So I said, we'll just come in this way and we'll wrap things up.
So
almost popped out of a drawer.
I was going to say, do you have a drawer big enough we can put Natalie in and then we pull
Absolutely.
It out and also Natalie pops out of the drawer, out of the shelf, Genie?
I mean, there'd be worse ways to pop out and surprise everyone, so that might be.
Well, she'll fit in our smallest drawer that holds 100 pounds.
So that's not true.
There you go. Hey, so you've got something really great coming up in the next hour.
I do. So in our next hour, we're kicking things off in the kitchen with flour. Okay, now flour, they have amazing pastas, but there's one dish that they make that involves olives that you don't want to miss when you're there, so we're making them in the kitchen.
Is there goat
today.
Cheese involved?
I believe so.
I think there's
a lot of action happening. So stay tuned. Don't go anywhere. We will be right back with the second hour.
Don't scare me.